As the number of cases keep growing, San Antonio emergency rooms are prepared for a surge. Meanwhile, doctors are warning about hidden symptoms of coronavirus. Eyewitness News reporter Henry Ramos starts us off tonight.
Our biggest challenge currently is fear of the unknown.
Dr. Ralph Raviello is in charge of emergency medicine at University Health System.
We don't like to panic, but we want to expect and prepare for the worst.
Preparing for scenes like this outside of hospitals in major cities like in New York. Hospital staff there overwhelmed with the surge in coronavirus patients.
But if you follow, you know, the numbers and the patterns from the other cities, we are probably very early in our COVID exposure. And we do have the potential to mirror any other major city, but I think we got ahead of it pretty early, much earlier than some of the other cities.
Not knowing what's to come is daunting, but Dr. Raviello says staff at University Hospital are ready.
Making sure we have the resources, the physicians, the nurses, the staff, the equipment to take care of patients.
During this coronavirus fight, Dr. Raviello and other physicians nationwide are coming across new symptoms.
We're also hearing of cases where patients are reporting loss of taste, loss of smell, and are coming up COVID positive.
As they care for patients who fear they have the virus, University Hospital is hoping to avoid a large spike in cases all at once.
I think we're as prepared as we can be, and we're just going to have to wait and see what happens.
Henry joins us live at University Hospital. Has the ER there been packed with patients, Henry?
Deborah, quite the opposite. I've learned today, since the coronavirus outbreak, overall volume is down at most ERs here in San Antonio, meaning patients are getting treated elsewhere or simply staying at home. So the ER doctors here, even though that may be the case, they're still working round the clock like the staff here. I'm told that the doctors here are helping with screenings in the community, meaning that they're talking to patients over the phone while not even on the job. Live here in the Medical Center, Henry Ramos, KINS 5, Eyewitness News.